Alberta's oil sands are contained within the Western Canadian Sedimentary Basin, which holds most of Canada's onshore oil reserves. Oil sands deposits are located mostly within Alberta's borders, split into three different geological areas: Peace River, Cold Lake, and the Athabasca region, which is centered around the city of Fort McMurray. There are an estimated 1.8 trillion barrels of oil in the oil sands, but less than 10% of those barrels can be economically recovered with current technology. That works out to about 160 billion barrels of oil, representing about 96% of the country's total oil reserves, placing Canada fourth after Venezuela, Saudi Arabia, and Iran. Oil sands production grew from just 200,000 barrels per day in the early 1980s to over a million in 2004, 2 million by 2013, and topped 3 million barrels per day by 2018. About half of those barrels are extracted in situ, without disturbing any land, and the other half is extracted using traditional surface mining techniques. Let's take a look at how it all began, starting from the very beginning. The very first written recording of oil sands deposits dates back to 1715. A Hudson's Bay employee received reports of a gum or black pitch found along the banks of the Athabasca River from a Chippewayan woman. Explorers Peter Pond and Alexander Mackenzie would make similar observations in the late 1700s, referring to bituminous fountains found along riverbanks, which gave off a coal-like smell when heated. Local First Nations peoples would mix the bitumen with spruce gum to waterproof their canoes. Several government-sponsored expeditions were carried out in the late 1800s. Geologists John McCoon and Robert Bell mapped out oil sands deposits in the Athabasca area with the aim of assessing any potential for future economic development. In the early 1900s, engineer Sidney Ells began a detailed survey of the Athabasca River, kicking off three decades of oil sands research. Dr. Carl Clark would later perfect a technique for extracting bitumen from the oil sands using just hot water, forming the basis for commercial development of mined oil sands. In 1929, Bitumount, located on the current-day Fort Hills lease, became Alberta's first privately funded commercial oil sands plant. The property was developed by PEI entrepreneur Robert Fitzsimmons, producing asphalt for use as roofing and road paving material. In 1959, Shell successfully recovered bitumen in situ from Lease 13 in the Athabasca region using steam flooding and an alkaline solution. Shell proposed a 100,000 barrel per day commercial plant, but couldn't get approval from the Alberta government. They eventually walked away from the project in 1968. Using a portable generator, Imperial Oil drilled four wells in the Cold Lake area in 1964 and began testing an in-situ process known as cyclic steam stimulation, developed by Imperial engineer Dr. Roger Butler. The process was adopted from huff and puff technology that was being used in California at the time. Also in 1964, Great Canadian Oil Sands, who would later become Suncor Energy, began construction of an oil sands mine and bitumen upgrader just north of Fort McMurray. The $250 million project, now known as Suncor's Base Plant, was the largest private investment in Canada's history at the time. The Syncrude Consortium was also established that same year. The company consisted of a small group of geologists, engineers, planners, and inventors, headed by Imperial Oil employee Frank Spragans. Great Canadian Oil Sands completed construction of the base mine and upgrader in 1967, making it the first large-scale commercial development in the oil sands. Imperial began testing in-situ bitumen production at its Lemming pilot in 1975 using cyclic steam stimulation. Lemming was the first successful pilot in the Cold Lake area. After 5 years of construction and with the help of government funding, Syncrude's Mildred Lake started up in the fall of 1978, becoming the second commercial development in the Fort McMurray area. The base mine and Mildred Lake upgrader produced 1 million barrels of oil in just its first year of operation. In 1985, Imperial commercialized the very first in-situ production facility in the oil sands using CSS technology. Shell began in-situ production at Peace River just 1 year later using a very similar process. With the help of Dr. Roger Butler, the Alberta government opened the underground test facility just west of Syncrude in 1987. UTF consisted of vertical mine shafts and horizontal tunnels that allowed for the installation of horizontal wells within the oil sands deposit. The facility was instrumental in the development of steam-assisted gravity drainage technology. A number of small-scale in-situ pilots were developed through the 1990s, including Primrose, Foster Creek, Surmont, and the Hanging Stone Demo Plant. Encana's Foster Creek, now operated by Cenovus Energy, became the very first commercial SAGD facility in the oil sands in 2001 and the very first to be located in the Athabasca Basin. With the help of Chevron and Western Oil Sands, Shell completed construction of the Athabasca Oil Sands Project in 2002, the largest facility to be built in the oil sands since Syncrude. AOSP included both the Muskeg River Mine and Scotford Upgrader, which was built 400 kilometers away near Edmonton. Scotford was the first and only bitumen upgrader to be decoupled from the mine site. Within a couple of years, total oil sands production reached 1 million barrels per day for the first time in history. In 2009, Canadian Natural Resources commissioned Horizon, the fourth mega mine and upgrader in the oil sands. The ramp-up of Horizon would bring total oil sands production to 1.5 million barrels per day. Higher oil prices and advancements in horizontal drilling technology would help spur development of several large SAGD facilities. In-situ bitumen extraction would overtake mining in 2012, pushing total oil sands production to just over 2 million barrels per day. In 2013, Imperial commenced mining operations at Kuril, using a new technology that produced a lighter, cleaner, marketable bitumen. Kuril was the very first standalone mining operation to be built without an upgrader. After a number of stops and starts, Fort Hills was the sixth and last mining operation in the oil sands and the second mine to be built without an upgrader. The facility began producing bitumen in 2018, pushing total bitumen production to over 3 million barrels per day. Bitumen production from both mining and in-situ facilities reached an annualized record of 3.3 million barrels per day in 2022, almost evenly split between the two extraction technologies. To learn more about Canada's oil sands and the different operating facilities, please check out our website at the links below. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.